All right, you guys, Tech and Ninja here, and I'm just doing a quick little, clean up of the last few trophies I have to get. So, without further ado, let's finish up those trophies and skedaddle along. So I've only got like about 3 or 4 missions left to fully get the gold on, and otherwise just have a few more little things to find, so that'll probably take like an hour at most. So this will basically just this will just be a short stream. One sec, guys. How many points do I need for that? 6,000 points, apparently. Shouldn't be too hard. I wish that skill was a bit more reliant. I wonder if I can pick these up. Alright, so 6,000 points apparently. I just love how this mission is just, you know, clean up a bunch of junk. I'll get the bigger items over here. But yeah, now we're playing garbage disposal. This one might actually be a bit hard to, this might actually be a little bit hard to get, the trophy on. Yeah, I think this one might be a little bit tricky to get it gone. I'm gonna have to look up, how to get it. Okay, apparently you hold it down. Well, that makes sense. Well, he's gotta be, I reckon he's gotta be worth something. Oh, they are. That was worth a bit, eh? I reckon this might put me to about 5,000 maybe? Oh shit, well, more than 5,000. Very nice. Right, now I just need a few more smaller items to get that number up. We got the minimum? Yes, we do. Gotta go fast. Gold medal. People are actually trying to get higher than that. Look, mommy, I got 5 million points on a challengey high score, dude, dad. Alright, what challenge we got next? I think we're just about done with this area. Actually no, I've got to do this quickly. And then once we've done that, should be pretty much done with this area. I think the Twitch counter's kind of bugged, because I know me and Justin are watching it, but it says no one's watching it, so that's kind of bugged. Or maybe me and Justin don't exist. Meow. Hmm. Chat's working. Or SpaghettiOs. Uh-oh. Ripperoni, pepperoni, rice-a-roni. Flat. Enemies. Right in the butt. Oh. Really? Splat. Pretty legit hitting up for his ship. I think because of no gravity, I think my kicks are being weaker as well. Sounds like Metal Gear Solid, sort of sounds like Metal Gear Solid Codec Nose, doesn't it, Justin? Like the way it goes, clutching. This is Solid Cat. I've infiltrated Shadow Moses. Solid Cat, Liquid Cat, Solidus Cat, Naked Cat. What are SpaghettiOs? Alright, let's skedaddle up to the ship again. Gotta go fast. Uh-oh, there's a lot of enemies there. Oh, oh, SpaghettiOs. I'm crashing this plane with no survivors. I hope it's not going to be one of those stupid, like, you know, affinity spawning enemies or some bullshit. I hate that. A lot of fire, homies. Oh shit. It burns. Gonorrhea. Gonorrhea burns. Alright, where's some damn water towers at? Is that a water tower up there? Yes, it is. Three water towers. Even better. Right, that should hold off the ship for a little bit. Alright, let's get rid of some of these fires. Find some more water towers, there we go. But yeah, those Nevi was getting caught part of the plan. I'm crashing this airship with no survivors. Wandering. Oh shit. Oh, you piece of shit. Oh, you piece of shit. You hit me when I was trying to get the water. Really? I'm just gonna stop the fire in the ship first. Alright, that should keep it fine for now. Just gonna get some more water. Can I grab that? No, I can't grab that. Too big. That's what she said. Alright, I think we're almost good here. Just gotta. There's one more fire in the ship and one more fire on top of the thing. Just gotta find a couple more water towers. Piss off. How did that not hit? Let's try it again. Fuck off. Get bloody bullet spam. Alright, if I get one more fire on the ground, that should keep me going until, Right, there's one more fire on the ground somewhere or something. That should, Where are they? Where are they? Yes, game. I said chuck the fire at, I totally said chuck the, water at the enemy. God, chill ship. I'm obviously trying to, you know, stop the fire. Oh, fuck you. Might as well checkpoint it. That's stupid. Just infinity spawning enemies make you drop shit when you get hit. It's pretty frustrating. I remember this one was giving me a bit of a headache on the Vita as well. Like, the only annoyance for getting a platinum on the Vita version, this one is, it's just this mission, really. This mission plus, a couple of the, side missions. Fuck. And I'll be right back, there's a bloody mosquito or something around me, I gotta get some spray. Sorry about that, I wasn't sure if it was a mosquito, or it was, you know, it's like those stupid-ass little bugs that try to, like, become friends with people, like, hey, a human, I'm gonna fly around his face. It was probably one of those bugs, you know, Like, humans are my friends! Whee! I gotta grab two at once. Let's take care of this ship quickly before we go back to the other ones. Oh, fuck off. That's what I mean, I hate these things. Fuck off. Annoying. Where's the damn water towers? That's what I mean, it's just infinity spawning enemies shuffled out of fire. See, oh my god, fuck off. I have to, like, autistically scream every time I get hit by the farm by an enemy. There's all the damn water towers, there's one over there. I'm just gonna fly up. Should give me enough time for my thing to regenerate again. Oh, fuck off. I was touching that. See what I mean? How this mission's kinda awful? Like, literally touching it, and it doesn't count. Fuck off with your new fires. So you can kill them, but they'll just come back again. See what I mean, how annoying this mission is? You kill the enemy, they just respawn again. How is there no water things up here? Kinda dumb. That's what I mean, this mission is shit. Right, where's the last two fires at? One over there. So what I mean, look, oh my god, more fires. Fuck off. I just need one more. Oh, Jesus, fuck. Thanks for that. Like I said, this mission is a pain in the butt. One more enemy left down here, apparently. Oh, one of these big cunts. Go away. These ones are really annoying to hit. Yeah, see how my kick's all gold now? That's because I got the maximum upgrade for it. So I'm like, really strong kick. Hang on a sec. Alright, sorry about that, guys. Holla to you, too. Bueno, friendo. Yeah. Fuck this. Fuck this military shit. All they care about is numbers. But I'm doing shit my own way. I'm a strong independent cat who don't need no, army, military. I'm a strong independent, tanned gravity changer. See, all the DLCs say that's a story for another time, so I'm gonna assume that Gravity Rush 2 will, you know, Gravity Rush 2 will probably go back to the, DLC stuff, you know what I mean? Alright, what have we got left to do for trophies? Have I done both the Batum ones? Yes, I have. I just need to find a place to get me a bit closer to it. Oops, that was the accident. Didn't want to use that. Alright, I'm going to the sewers. Hey, Justin, I think I found your wifey down there. Is it? Alright, can I maximize my skills or am I still sort of capped? Sweet, I got maximum rank, Gravity Queen. Yay. No, but seriously, how about Persona 5 though? Persona 5's got great waifus. You got the hacker waifu and you got the Phantom Thief waifu. So 500 points, huh? How much points is that meant to be? Like 500 points? 20 people? Or is that fucking like 30, 25 people or something? I'm sure I can do that easy. Oh, they're worth a bit more. Must be worth more points the longer you go or something. I don't know. So 500 points, shouldn't be too bad to get. I've got that skill maxed as well, so... So yeah, the maximum version ability can take a lot of people once, so... this shouldn't be too bad. Like, see that guy by himself? What I'll do is I'll bring him closer to his buddies. Bring you here as well. I'll just get rid of you. And look at how they're stacked though. That's kind of funny, isn't it? All right, now I've got five people. One, see? That should cut trips a bit. There we go. I got the points already. I reckon just a couple more people, you know, for shits and gigs, and then that would be good. Build that. I'm gonna build that wall. Alright, now we just let it time out. Now we just let time out. True Challenger and Silver Lining. All that glitters. There you go. I got all the base trophies. All the base challenges. Because there's the main side missions and there's the DLC side missions. All right. Next up, we'll do Yep. Ripperoni, pepperoni. Right, with Rift Plane Sliding Race. Let's do this. Rift pepperonis, pepperonis. Gravity cat. there's collateral damage to be expected. Collateral damage numbers are within our within well-defined parameters. All right, so 2 minutes. Let's see how this goes. All right, 2 minutes for 24 checkpoints. Lucky I can, oh, fuck off. That's a load of bullshit. Just put a drop right there. Gotta go fast. We pass Q. You're too gay. Sonic's name means the game. You can't use bloody gravity dash. Look how long it takes to respawn. It's like, come on, stop taking my time up. Yay. See, I mean, even with the full upgrade, it still is kind of tricky. Special Forces. Mushroom slider. Hey, Lamia, slide that mushroom down your throat. And truffle shifter. Truffle slider. Sweet. We're getting close, baby. Alright, there's only one more DLC trophy to get, which is the Fireproof Racer. Only one more challenge left? So that one... Yep, only one left. I've got to say, Apple laptops charge really fast. I mean, I put this thing on like, what, 40 minutes ago, 40-ish minutes ago, and it's like 6% charge. Hey, LeMaire. Talking about LeMaire, I've got a funny picture to send you later on Facebook. About LeMaire's. Alright, this one's the last one to do. God, stop. See, look, it's trying to make me kick the... It's trying to make me kick the objects, and I want it to kick the objects. I want to fucking slide. That's what I mean. These controls piss me off sometimes. Just... Yes, I totally want to kick an object in the face. And then this happens. Like, no, I don't want to get stuck there. See, fuck off. See, stuff hits you, just fucks up your, just fucks up your gravity shifting really bad. See what I mean? I don't want to go there, fuck. Like, I mean, the controls aren't bad, it's just shifting sometimes is really fucking annoying. Then you got shit trying to hit you like that. See, oh my god, see, stop. See what I mean? Not really controls, it's just more bouncing off shit and hitting stuff. It just gets annoying. See, just then, like, how would it just wouldn't let me slide when it's like, hello, I want to slide. I doubt I'm gonna get this. That's what I mean, this one is like, I reckon out of all of them, this one's probably the most frustrating to do. Just because, like I said, you just bounce off shit and the enemies hit you out of your bloody gravity shifting. No, it wouldn't be a problem if, like, they hit you and you still shift. No, this is like one of the DLC ones, so that's kind of why it's meant to be hard. See, then there's that. Look, you literally have to fucking put your whole dick in that thing to get it. But see what I'm doing? How I'm like bouncing off it. You gotta kind of like softly bounce off the thing so you can keep your gravity up. See, fuck off. Just stops you fucking hitting. That's what you want to do. You want to try to not exactly touch it fully. Wow, that camera's really glitching up hard. I probably won't even get this one either, knowing my luck. Wait, I might get lucky to get this one. See, that's what I mean. It's like, fuck off. Don't hit me. See? That's what I mean. It's stupid, this one. You put one of those spiky things right in the way of the object. It's like, thanks. You kind of unshift gravity right before you hit it, so you kind of bounce off it. So what I mean, how I kind of like, fuck off. I reckon I might have it this time. Let's go watch those spikes. That's all it is really to it. Fuck off, see what I mean? I couldn't even see what hit me. It's like, yes, hit me with invisible things that I can't even, see, have enough time to attack, react to. Oh my god, see that? See what I mean? It's fucking falling, it's fucking hitting on that stupid thing. Oh, I reckon I got it this time. Look how much time I saved this time. You reckon I got this, don't you? This time. Yay! And very nice. Eat shit. Whoa, look at that. 214. Either no one played this mission, or I just happened to go to semi-decent time. A little from column A, a little from column B. Alright, let's go find the rest of the missing Mimas. Alright, so we're in Playjohn, so there's apparently two missing in here. So one is apparently just above the elephant thing, which is who knows where. Hi back, I'm dead. You missed it. I did a pretty nifty run of that, that stupid last fire level I was doing. I managed to get, like, 30 seconds, about 30 seconds less than the, gold time. Or quicker. Which put me, like, 214 in the world. Alright, so apparently this next one's... this missing person's... somewhere under there, apparently, how the fuck do we get to them? So that mark is not exactly where they roughly are, but actually, all right. So I can tell I found him if I find a little like speech icon, which could be anywhere. It could even be under the stage, you know, for all intents and purposes. Oh, there we go. There they are. Yeah, Justin, you've been listening to this, like, you've been watching this game pretty much the whole run. The orchestra score is pretty damn good, isn't it? Ripperoni, pepperoni. Right, where's the next one at? Alright, next one's apparently closer towards, apparently just over there somewhere. So might be just under here somewhere. Kipo. I love that Kipo thing. The thing is, you just randomly use Kipo, but I actually know how it's meant to be, like, you know, Kappa and Meepo, as in, like, Meepo from bloody, Dota 2. Right, so Industria we go. So first up for Industria looks to be near looks to be near that one. Wait, what are you talking about? I use the same way I see other people using it. Oh yeah, the Kipo, yeah. What's funny is, just like, I actually know what it means. People just go, Kipo, 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 it's just like... But do you know what it actually means? You use this meme, but do you know where this meme actually comes from? You can't just use a meme without context. Need a bit more dog in here. Yeah, see? Some emoticons don't show up. I think only like the the first bunch of ones show up, but the newer ones don't. Like I think Oh My Dogs and Hola One are just Hey Everyone. I think those are just too new for the PS4. Twitch normies. Get out, normies. Right, where's this next one? On top of the tower, in the middle. So, just over there? Or is that somewhere else? No, it looks like it's just over. Wait, is it over there? I'm so confused. Where? Is it just over there? On the roof of the train station. Is that the roof of the train station? No, that's... Wait. I was already on the roof of the train station. So which one am I at now? Okay, I think I got the wrong one. Right. Apparently there should be another one over there somewhere or something. Up there, up here, or down everywhere. Probably down here maybe? Wait, so where's that one supposed to be? Yeah, boat line station. Maybe I've got that one already. I think I might have. Wait, no, hang on. That's there. So that would apparently be over there. I think I have this one already. So, alright, let's go look for the next one then. Actually, to double check, we'll go to another area quickly, and then we'll come back, see if it says there's one there or not. So we'll just jump out of here. Alright, so play June. And now back to Industria. Alright, we've got all Industria ones. So, Vendor Centra then. So, first one up looks to be, near a manhole of sorts. Building. In the dick butt. Okay, looks like there's one near that mission apparently somewhere, so Yeah, Justin, funny story, I was gonna lend this game to a couple of, a couple of friends, hey, I was gonna lend it to one friend, but he, bought it, a few days later, and then another friend already has it, but I didn't realize he had it, and then another friend, turns out he's actually borrowing off a friend after they're finished, so, just gonna say, so if you ever get a PS4, Justin, I'll lend you this game so you can play it yourself. I mean, with the PS4 Neo coming in November, I mean, the original PS4 will go down in price, you know what I mean? Like, my guess is PS4 Neo comes out, or before it comes out, they'll start clearing off normal PS4s. So who knows? You might be able to get a new PS4 $300 soon. Alright, so a little bit towards the east. Which way's east? That way. The other way. Up on this building somewhere? This one might be a little tricky to find. Not here we go. I knew it was one of those buildings around here. So I was just thinking something about it. For a second I thought one of my bundles was a bit screwy, but it's perfectly fine. I'm just on drug. Yeah, but dude, think about it. By the time they fully lock down the PS4 Neo and the pricing and all that shit, I bet you I can guarantee you anything. Dude, I can guarantee you anything by the time PS4 Neo once they've worked everything out, I bet you anything PS3s will drop down to $300 or some shit. And I'm pretty sure you can find some new PS3s cheap on eBay or maybe JB Hi-Fi or something. $200 or less, maybe. Or you can do what I did. Find someone selling them on eBay who's hardly used it. Like I said, my PS3 was a used one on eBay for $150. But, it turned out, the guy said I think the guy had won it as a prize, or I think he got it as a birthday present or some shit like that, I don't know. And he didn't want it, so he sold it on eBay. And when I actually got... So I got the PS3 a few days later, after I bought it off him, and I checked the trophies. And I reckon, judging from the trophies, I reckon he barely used the PS3 for maybe 10 hours at most. So this guy basically would have gotten off PS3, played a couple of his games, and then gone, yeah, PS3 sucks, eBay. And I'm like, your loss is my gain. So who knows, Justin, maybe you find the same predicament as me, you find someone who's like, me don't want PS3, me don't like your Christmas present, me want women's for present and monies, not PS3. So then you go to eBay and you find Mr. Wingy Pants McWinge selling a PS3 for cheap. Everyone wins in the end. Alright, where's this next one? Apparently just to the right of this manhole? Oh, Justin, I'm letting off some bad gas. I had way too much pizza earlier. It's like, oh, the pizza's fighting back. Ay, mi no gusta, caramba. Alright, this person's apparently over towards this direction. No, I streamed it from the PC, dude. You have to use a capture card if you want to do PS3. A good capture card is like $150, $200, depending on what you're looking at, like brand wise. PS4 lets you, PS4 lets you stream and record clips. So when you eventually, if you eventually get Idolmaster on PS4, you can just save clips of random shit. Right, so this next person is, okay, apparently down there somewhere. Probably directly underneath me here somewhere. There we go. Oh, that Pixar is fighting back. I'm just gonna skip these conversations, I don't really care about them. Blah blah blah, gravity gravity, shmavity shmavity, boom boom boom, boom boom boom. Don't forget, I think for the most part you need a decentish system for capturing, but your laptop might cut it, I'm not sure. You might have to do some research to see if your laptop will be fast enough for a capture card. Like, I'm pretty sure you can just ask. I'm pretty sure there's a Reddit for capture cards, or even just a Reddit for PC gaming. What you should do, okay, what I want to do is, Justin, go to the PC gaming Reddit, or look for a capture card one, or just something like that. Otherwise, go to the PC gaming subreddit and ask them if your laptop will be good enough to run a capture card on. You're not capturing like game on your computer, but you're capturing like a PS3. So, like, ask him if that will be fast enough to, like, you know, run a PS3 capturing through. Because you don't want to pick up a capture card and then find out your computer just doesn't have enough, like, you know, just has not enough resources for it. I mean, you said it yourself, like, your laptop is semi-decent, so it should be able to run a capture card for the PS3 fine, but yeah, just go post on Reddit and just make sure, you know, like, you don't want to, like, you know, buy a $200 graphics card, $200 capture card, and then find out your laptop's just not good enough. So yeah, and make sure when you post, like, state that you're not going to be really capturing any PC footage, just PS3 footage. So it's really the PS3 that's doing all the, like, you know, rendering and shit. So that shouldn't take up, like, as much resources for the PS3, so just check with Reddit. Alright. I'm just gonna quickly check something over here. Alright, so let's see. So, Playjun, all done. If you do make a post on Reddit, chuck me a link so I can have a look at it. But yeah, the PC gaming Reddit should pretty much help you with working out if your computer's powerful enough or not. Why the hell didn't the marker show up, or did I just miss it? I'm gonna have to check again. No, this time I'm actually gonna look in the corner and make sure I don't miss the number. So, alright, so I've got all the ones in this upstairs area. So let's go back to a manhole. Cause to get the other ones, you actually have to go to another dimension. So, spooky magic. Splat. So to go back to dimension, you have to go, nope. Alright, so let's quickly save. Alright, so we want to go to the ruins. See, creepy old man. He's flashing me. Help, I'm being sucked in. Alright, so at the fourth flower. Like it just goes pew. I need to kill these things. These guys keep spawning enemies. No spawning enemies. Oh god, stop moving. You know what? Fuck it. Eat shit and die. I think one of those one of the trophies to kill those is to kill these like rare powerful nevies, but I think one of them's in the ruins, I'm not sure. I'll have a look around. How is he still alive? Got one more thing left to hit. Alright, so at top of that tower apparently, which tower? This tower? I'm confused. Right, let's just get my gravity back up into, okay, so up top of here or something maybe? Ah, there we go. Okay, so apparently, like, all right. So there's every of these. So every one of these planes has a special enemy. So where is it? All right. So I want to go back to the third flower. Under here apparently, or under there or something else. Whoa. Jesus. That damage. Oh, nice. Oh, wow, look at that, Jesus. So much coins. So many great candies. So much to Gashi Kashi. I think I have more than enough to upgrade my skills fully. Alright, so that's one of the three rare games down. Alright, so where's the next person? Directly below the fifth flower, so that means back up to where we have to go. Alright, so apparently from the 5th flower you go to the 6th flower and then from there... So apparently down here somewhere? Right, found jewel.
You thought you could escape from me. You thought the hiding is your ally. I was born into hiding, shaped by it.
Alright, how many plain ones are left? One, two... Three, four. Wait, four of them? Am I missing one? Or is there one in the other place? Oh, there's one in Batum. Okay, yeah, there's one in Batum. Let's go get the Batum one. I love this ability, it's just sit there, pew 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 pew. Alright, now how the hell do we get out of here? Do I just quit out or something? Where are they? Or do I just follow that out of here or something? Maybe I'll just follow that one and takes me back to the exit or something. Okay, I have to retake the bosses on basically then, okay. Should be easy, look how powerful I am. Ripperati pepperati. Alright, should get back. How do I get back? Oh, there you go. It's automatic. The looks of it. Take me to Batum. Spooky. Look into my eyes. Very spook. Right, there's two travelers down here apparently. Apparently there's one over here. Oh, there you are. You try to be sneaky cheeky. Alright, next one's just a little bit to the left of that one, apparently. Might have this one already, I'm not sure. Let's have a look. Alright, okay, I'm just right roughly where it should be, so it might just be up here somewhere. Right in the right spot. Pretty much in the right spot, so... One of the ones in the planes, in those other two planes, I've already got one of those, so I'm actually really close to the end. Alright, so we've got the Mirage, now we have the Inferno, so let's go to the Inferno. Find out how to get here first. Wait, no, we have to talk to her to get out of there. Return to the memes. Look into my eyes. Alright, so to the Inferno we go. Take me down to the Inferno City with a meme scream. Alright. Directly above the first flower, so what, pretty much right near the start? I like how there's just a gem hiding here right at the edge. Directly above the first floor, so where's the first flower from here? Just down here somewhere? Okay, hang on. Directly above the first flower on the scaffolding. So what, over there somewhere? There we go. You think you can hide from your ally? Alright, so the second flower is where the enemy is. Alright, so second flower enemy. We're doing it, Justin. So close to that plaque trophy, I can smell it. Tastes like ice cream. Tastes like ice cream waffles. Let's just kill these fuckers quickly. The ice cream emoticon. Alright, so let's see. Second flower, fly underneath. So what, directly under the flower somewhere? Follow bridge structure. Like there? Oh, that's a big guy for you. Oh, I need to recover my health again. Look how much damage this guy does, it's so annoying. Right, he's almost dead. There we go. Very nice. Whoa, look at that payday. Jesus. Money, money, money. So much money. In a mean man's world. Alright, now I'm kinda lost, so Okay, let's just kill him this way. It's easier. Let's get some health ball here as well. A bit of health there. Here's a health, there's a health everywhere, a health, health. Talking about ice cream waffles, and in the morning, I'm making waffles. Donkey, get out of my swamp. Oh, talking about swamp, oh man, there is so many bloody Pokemon gyms nearby. I'm just gonna have to, like, one day, just, you know, just do a giant ass walk around the block, just go yoink, yoink, yoink. This is my swamp. Alright. Location for the third flower drop below. Standing on a rock, apparently. Oh, I see you. No, that's not it. So one of these things, there we go. Alright. Only one more left to find in the Mirage place. I've got the plat for this in the Vita, and I'm actually literally like two trophies or something off the plat on PS4. I'm just gonna wait for my ability to come back. Be quicker that way. Well, actually not. Okay, let's just kill him. Nah, you should get to platinum. I mean, like, a couple of the challenges and things are like, there's only about two trophies really that are annoying to get, but for the most part, I'll give this maybe a 4 out of 10, a 5 out of 10 difficulty for platinum. Yeah, the sliding side missions were definitely more annoying on the Vita. The controls, like, thank God on this, like, the slide and the dodge are on buttons. So it's less of a headache. Alright, so I think we're pretty close to the platinum, I'm pretty sure. 3 more trophies. Well, technically 2 more trophies, because, you know, like, you know how the platinum, once you get the second to last trophy, you get the platinum. So if you think about it, like, if a game has, like, this game's got 64 trophies, but technically you can say it's got 63 trophies, because Once you get the second to last one, you get the platinum as well, so yeah. So what I'll do is talk to one more of those couples and one more thing. So after the Mirage. But yeah, Memelef, this game is really good on the PS4. Like, I mean, just everything looks so much better, the 60 FPS, the controls feel nicer. You can still use the touchpad, you know, like for dodging and shit. But nah, for the most part, yeah, this is a really good remaster, and I'm pretty damn hype as fuck for Gravity Rush 2, so I'm hoping E3 next month. I really hope they shed some more light on Gravity Rush 2. Alright, so the last one's at the third flower, while the last ghost is near the first flower. Like, funny story, I'm pretty certain Gravity Rush 2 was meant to be originally on the Vita, but I think just the fact that the Vita was doing pretty poorly on, you know, initially, so, and the sales were pretty low, so I think what happens is, I think they pretty much, you know, shit-canned Gravity Rush 2, and then kind of, you know, revived it onto the PS4. So, like, I think initially, if the Vita had done a lot better sale-wise, in terms of hardware and software, they would have definitely done Gravity Rush 2 on the Vita and PS4. But you know, I'm kind of curious, is Persona 5? Persona 5 not coming out in Vita in Japan like I thought it would be. It's coming out in PS3 in Japan. I'm surprised Atlus isn't releasing Persona 5 on the Vita. Like, that's pretty much like, what, two of the last PS3 games? Odin Sphere and Persona 5. Like, pretty much the last of the PS3 Vita game, PS3 games. Alright, well, I was meant to get going, so near that first flower was meant to be another one of those persons you talk to on a mushroom. But I think I might have that person already. Unless they're over there or something. Oh no, there we go. I think this might be the last one that I need. Well, the Vita is still kicking in Japan though. The Vita is very strong in Japan. There we go. Lost some time and space. So what's funny is all the DLC missions and that side quest here with the mysterious couple, those don't actually get resolved in this game. So I'm gonna assume, if anything, you'll probably see them again in Gravity Rush 2. Alright, so where are we going now? The last thing to find is at the third flower, was it? Third flower. And I mean, the only reason the Vita is still alive in the Western countries is mainly because all the Vita releases now are either indie games or Japanese RPGs. And I mean, there's still quite a few Japanese RPGs on track for the Vita this year, so I mean, at least in terms of, like, things like Japanese, JRPG is one of my most favourite categories, so at least for me, the Vita's not dead. And I mean, every year people thought the Vita was done for, no more games, but I mean, there is still a pretty killer Vita lineup for this year. So, and I'm pretty sure Japan's not giving up, the third-party devs not giving up on the Vita either, so I mean, At this rate, if the Vita goes up to, like, if the Vita goes at least to 2017, I'm happy with that. Cause you got those guys who made What was the name of them? I forgot their name, but they're the ones who make all the dungeon crawlers, like Operation Abyss and... what's the other one they make? But all I know is, like, there's three or four different, like, devs on the Vita making dungeon crawlers. So there's plenty of dungeon crawlers to go on the Vita, and we're getting pretty much majority of them, and companies like Bandai Namco and Atlus and them are still pretty much supporting the Vita pretty good. So the Vita's got a bit of life to it still, which is kind of funny because Vita means life. Just today I picked up Stranger of Sword City. You heard of that one? That's another like little dungeon crawler. And I reckon at some point, once I've run out of game to play, I reckon I'm gonna pick up, you heard of Ray Gigant? Ray Gigant's another dungeon crawler, but there's a really cool element to it. Like, you attack the enemies until you run out of, like, this energy kind of, like energy thing, and then to regain it, you have to do this sort of, like, music minigame in the battle. So, it's pretty cool. Alright, so I'm trying to find a red... Oh, there you go. For that. Oh, here we go. Now, can I kill this one using the drill attack, or is it gonna, like, bullshit me? Aww, I have to kill it normally. Yeah, Tokyo Xanadu, they're the same guys who made Operation Abyss, Operation Tokyo or whatever. Jeez, why won't this guy die? Nanomachines, son. My body's full of them. Yeah, I know Falcom's been supporting the Vita pretty well still. I mean, there's like what? There's still the Trials Cold Steel 2 coming out for it as well, here. They're still making the new Wise game, that's coming out to PS4 and Vita. Oh, so many gems. Hey, there we go, platinum trophy obtained. I wish you could show it though. I mean, basically any friends notification or like party notification or even trophies, all that's blurred out. But basically those two pop-ups you just saw, one was the trophy for getting the boss here, and the other trophy was for was the final trophy. So, all right. So that's the plat trophy done. We did it, boys. We damn well did it. See, those enemies aren't too hard, they just do so much damage to you. Like, they take like bloody 30 hits to kill, and they take like 1/4 of your health every hit. Let's get out of this rift and then we can go save the game and we're done. This is actually my 13th platinum. I'm really close to another, I'm really close to another couple of platinums, actually. You know about Tales of Hearts R, right? I've only got 2 trophies on Tales of Hearts R to do, and about 5 trophies on Mega Dimension Neptunia. I'm MLG. Nah, I'm just usually like, mainly like, I don't really play games that much during the day. It's just mostly during the night. And yeah. Besides, this game takes about, like, you know, about 20 hours or so to platinum, but I reckon I already spent about, this is only about 12 hours, so I reckon, so I did about 8 hours of streaming, and plus 2, yeah, I reckon it only took me about 12 hours to get to platinum this time, when apparently the average time for platinum on this game is 15-25 hours. So I'm just that damn good. Yeah, I think I might skip over Zestiria because I've heard mixed things about it, but I'm hearing Tales of Berseria is gonna be pretty good, and apparently from the protagonist of Berseria seems pretty like badass, so yeah, I might have to give Berseria a check. Alright, so that's it for now for the stream, for tonight. But a friend of mine, I'm actually be streaming again in half an hour, so I'm just checking with a friend if he wants to play yet. So I'll tell you what, when my friend gets back from work, if he's able to, I'll be streaming Resident Evil 6 co-op, so it'll actually be me and someone else in the stream, like on voice chat, so you can hear us, like, you know, so you can hear us banter and meme and scream while we play Resident Evil 6 and shoot zombies. He should be back from work in about half an hour or a sec, but otherwise, if he comes back within an hour, I'll be streaming in an hour roughly, so anyway. Thanks for watching, guys. Stick around in an hour, because likely I'll be streaming Resident Evil 6 with them in an hour's time. If not, I'll be streaming tomorrow night. So I'll catch you guys then. Thanks for watching.